If you've been following my channel, then you probably remember my Lab Rax project, a 10-inch modular and 3D printable rack system that I designed to make it cheap and easy to build your own home lab. Well, today I've got something new to add to it. I've been working on a series of drive and SBC shelves, specifically aimed at building a customizable NAS inside the Lab Rax framework. You can use these as part of a bigger home lab setup, or just build a standalone NAS. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through some of the new components, show you how I designed and printed them, and then put together two different NAS builds, one using a Raspberry Pi 5 and one using the Zimaboard 2. A quick recap for anyone new here, the Lab Rack system is 10 inches wide, so it's a lot smaller than a standard 19-inch rack, but it still uses the same unit height and hole spacing, like most other 10-inch rack systems. So you can mix and match different modules from other systems too. The whole point is flexibility. You can start small and add shelves, computers, drives or networking gear as you go. Thanks to UGREEN for supporting today's video with their new MagFlow magnetic power bank. The MagFlow power bank supports the latest Qi2 25-watt wireless charging standard. So with the new iPhone 17 Pro, you'll be able to charge wirelessly to 50% in under 30 minutes. It also supports older wireless charging standards, so it still snaps onto my iPhone 14 magnetically and it'll just charge at a lower 15 watts. The MagFlow Powerbank's magnet holds the phone firmly in place, even if you're using the phone while charging. And this little screen shows you exactly how much battery you've got left, so there's no guessing involved. It's not just a wireless charger either. You've got a built-in braided USB-C cable that doubles up as a handy carrying strap alongside a second USB-C port. And they support 30-watt fast charging input and output, perfect for topping up or recharging the bank itself quickly and easily. You can even charge multiple devices at once through combinations of the wireless charger and USB-C ports. Paired with their MagFlow wireless charger, which conveniently folds up for travel, you can wirelessly charge both your iPhone and your AirPods. Speaking of travel, the 10,000 mAh capacity is flight friendly, and it'll fully recharge an iPhone twice, making it a perfect everyday or on-the-go travel companion. So if you're looking for a smart charging choice for your smartphone or portable devices, check out the new UGREEN MagFlow magnetic power bank and MagFlow wireless charger. I've put links to both of them in the video description below. So let's get into the new additions. I've designed four new shelves, two for drives and two for computers to run the NAS. First up is a 1U shelf that holds two 3.5-inch drives. Each bay has threaded brass insert mounting points for a SATA cable to be screwed in at the back. The drives are then installed in pull-out trays with screws through the sides. This arrangement makes swapping drives super easy. Although it makes the most sense to use 3.5-inch drives in these, the bays are dual purpose, so you can mount 2.5-inch drives in them as well. Then there's a 1U shelf for four 2.5-inch drives. These are again in pull-out trays, and the drives are secured with screws through the sides. This shelf also has mounting points for the same SATA cables that the 3.5-inch shelf has. So drives are easy to swap out too. I added a bracket to hold the top set of cables to make it easy to work on. This shelf is great if you're using SSDs or smaller mechanical drives for your NAS setup. Next, I've got a 1U shelf designed specifically for a Raspberry Pi 5 with the Radxa Penta SATA HAT. I've also added space to mount an I2C OLED stats display alongside it. Radxa's Penta SATA HAT has four SATA ports on the top and one eSATA port on the front, making it a great NAS controller option in just a single rack unit. The Pi stack is held in place on the shelf with some brass standoffs, and a ribbon cable I've soldered onto the I2C pins connects it to the display. Lastly, I designed a similar 1U shelf for the Zimaboard too. The Zimaboard's held in the tray with three screws on the sides, and it already has two SATA ports at the back. The shelf also allows a PCI Express SATA expansion card to be plugged in on the side, so with this board you can add even more drives and really scale up your build. This particular card has another 5 SATA ports for a total of 7. Like with the Lab Rax system, I designed all of these components specifically to be easily 3D printable, so they require very few supports and are sized to fit onto most common print beds. Now let's take a look at how they fit together in the actual build. I'm building both of them into this wide 5U rack, although the power rack only uses 4 units of space, so I'll have a spare unit for future expansion or accessories. Let's start out by building the power version. First up, at the top of the rack we've got a 1U shelf with our switch. This particular switch is a bit overkill for the power build, which only has gigabit Ethernet, but I like to add a 2.5 gig network adapter to one of the power's USB 3 ports, and this significantly improves file transfer speeds. Next we've got a 1U ventilation panel. This adds a bit of space between the switch and the power, which allows the SATA cables to plug in on the top of the power easily. Below that we've got the 1U power shelf with the Radxa Penta SATA HAT. This hat also has the benefit of being able to power the 4 drives and the 120mm fan on the top of the rack. That is if you use a good quality 12V power supply. I have run into power issues with some older models of 3.5-inch drives, which then causes them to drop out intermittently or struggle to spin up. If that occurs, you'll need to power them separately. Lastly, below that we've got 2 1U shelves, each carrying 2 3.5-inch drives. And that's our power NAS rack complete. I like to run Open Media Vault or OMV on the Power 5, which makes it quite straightforward to get a NAS up and running. With this arrangement, a 2.5 gig network adapter, and the drive set up in a RAID 5 configuration, I get write speeds of around 215 megabytes per second, and read speeds of around 240. There aren't a lot of options for going beyond 5 drives on a Power 5, mainly because of the single PCIe lane that's available for expansion. So that's why I made the second option for the Zimaboard too. Mine has 7 SATA ports, but you can add even more, depending on the expansion card that you use. For the Zimaboard setup, the switch is now better suited to the Zimaboard, which has dual 2.5 gig network ports. I've also left the 2 1U 3.5-inch drive shelves at the bottom. I'm replacing the ventilation panel with the Zimaboard shelf, and then below that I've got the 1U shelf with 4 2.5-inch SSDs. Since my Zimaboard setup has 7 ports, I've now got one more drive bay than I need, but I'll just keep that one as a spare. So this build now has a lot more storage potential thanks to the board's expandability. The Zimaboard is running Zima OS. It's super clean, user-friendly, and also makes it easy to get your drives pulled and accessible on your network. With this arrangement, I get faster writes of around 230 megabytes per second, and reads a little bit closer to 260, mainly because the Zimaboard's N150 CPU is more powerful than the Power 5's. You also have access to more adaptable storage and dual network ports. So overall, a more powerful setup. So there you have it. Two different NAS builds inside the Lab Rax system, one powered by the Power 5 and one powered by the Zimaboard 2. They're both customizable, easily 3D printable, and expandable as your home lab grows. Let me know in the comments section which build you'd go for. I'm really happy with how these new shelves turned out. They take the Lab Rax system from being a general purpose rack to a really capable NAS framework too. If you enjoyed this project and want to see more Homelab and 3D printing builds, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.